Hello everyone, our subject name is Machine Learning and Application. So under the unit 3, we will start. The today's topic is least square method. So let's see. So introduction part. So engineering, two types of application are to be encountered. The first one is the trend analysis. That means we have to predict the value of dependent variable, which may include the data point and interpolation between that data points. So we have to predict the value between the data points and the interpolation of that data points. And the next one, the applications are hypothesis testing. That means comparing existing mathematical model with that measured data. So curve fitting. So there are two general approaches for the curve fitting. First one is the least square regression and next one is the interpolation. So data exhibit a significant degree of scatter. The strategy to derive a single curve that represents the general trend of the data. That means it exhibits the degree of scattering. Scattering is to scatter the data on that curves. The next one is the interpolation. As we know that data is very precise and the strategy is to pass a curve, a series or curves through the each of the points. So the method of the least square is a standard approach. It is a standard approach to the approximate solution of overdetermined system. That is the set of equations in which there are more equations which are unknown. So the least square means the overall solution of that minimizes the sum of the square of the error which is made in the result of the every single equation. That means suppose a equation is given, okay, that equation having a solution. When we calculate the solution for that, sum of the all the square of error is to be made, and least square is the solution to minimize that all the sum of the square or the error which is made during that solving the equation. So the least square method is usually credited to Carl Friedrich Gauss in 1795, but it was first published by the Adrian Marie Langevin. So this is the scientist who firstly introduced the least square method in 1795, and after that the Adrian scientist was first published. So let's see what is scatter diagram. Okay, so find a relationship. If you want to find a relationship, by the way, the set of paired observation are given like x and y. So we have to plot the graph against that x and y. So sum of the variable which is represented at x side and sum of the variable which is represented by the y side. So we can say that x1, y1, then combination of x2, y2, and how many total number of points are given, we can say that up to that xn and yn, n sample. So the resulting diagram which is showing the collection of that dots is called as a scatter diagram. The collection of that various dot is nothing but the scatter diagram. And the smooth curve that is approximate the above set of the points is known as a approximate curve. Okay, when we draw the scatter diagram and that smooth curve is applied on the different point, it is known as the approximate curve. Then the working of the procedure is that, so let's see, to fit into the straight line equation, as we know that straight line equation is y equals to a plus bx, we have to substitute the observed n value in the equation. So total number of n values we have to given, and we have to fit the n values into that straight line equation. For the normal equation, the constant is summation of y equals to that total sample n into that a plus b summation of x. As we know that the sum points of y and x are almost to the n sample, like x1, y1, x2, y2, x3, y3. So we have to take the summation of that y. Then for that A, we have taken the n number of sample plus B summation of x. We also say that summation of xy equals to A summation of x plus b summation of x square. So solve this normal equation simultaneously and calculate the value for that a and b. And finally, we have to substitute the values of that a and b into that equation of y equals to ax plus bx, which is required the line to be fit. Okay, so this is the line to of fit equation to be generated, and we have to take the graph for that. Then how to fit that equation into the parabola? So as we know that the parabola equation is y equals to a plus bx plus cx square, which is given. Okay, so how to fit that equation into the normal equation? Then we have to take the summation of y plus na plus b summation of x plus c summation of x square, and then summation of x y for the simultaneously we have to take a summation of x plus b summation of x square plus c summation of x cube, and we have to take the x square of y summation equals to a summation of x square plus b summation of x cube plus c summation of x square. Then we have to solve this equation and we have to calculate the value of a comma b comma y. Then we have to substitute that a comma b comma c in the our parabola equation y equals to a plus bx plus cx square, which is the best fit equation for the parabola. So in general, for the curve we can write y equals to a plus bx plus cx square up to that some value up to k x as raised to m minus 1, which is written in the m normal equations. So the normal equation, for that normal equation, as we see that the value of a is unknown, which is obtained by multiplying the coefficient of a, and we have to add that. Then for the normal equation for the b, we have to obtain the multiply the equation for that coefficient of that b, and we have to add it, that is x. And for the normal equation of that c, we have to obtain by multiplying the equation by the coefficient of that c, that is x square, and we have to add it. So this equation we have to get for finding of that a, b and c. So consider some example. So we have to take first example for the straight line. So how to fit the straight line equation of x of y? The values are given. Suppose x of y, xi value is 1. For that correspondence value of yi is 0.5. As like that, we take the value of xi and yi. Then we calculate the summation of xi. So calculate 1 plus 2 plus 3 plus 4 plus 5 plus 6 plus 7 is total 28. So xi value we get 28. Then we calculate the total yi value 0.5, 2.5, 2, 4, 3.5, and we have to take the sum of all these to we get the summation of yi equals to 24. Then we have to multiply that xi with yi, and we have to calculate 1 multiply by 0.5, then xi yi get 0.5, 2 multiply by that 2.5 we get the 5, and all the values we have to calculate with xi with yi, and from this xi yi column, and finally we take the summation of that xi and y, then the summation we get 0.5 plus 5 plus 6 plus 16, and we get 119.5. The summation of xi yi is 119.5. Then we have to take the square of xi square. So xi square, 1 square is 1, 2 square is 4, 3 square is 9, 4 square is 16, up to that 7. Then we have to sum of that xi square, summation of that xi square, we get the 140, that is 1 plus 4 plus 9 plus 16 plus 25. Then the summation of xi square, we get 140. Then finally, we take the x bar and the y bar, that is 28 divided by 7, and y bar is 24 by 7. So 28 is summation of that xi, we take a 28 and n number of total sample. Total sample n, how many? 7 samples. So we divided that total sample n, so we get 4. And for the y bar, we take a summation of yi divided by total sample n, so we get 3.42857 value. So we get a value of x bar and y bar is 4 and 3.42. So we can check the xi yi to xi yi. So a1 is n of xy, n summation of x square minus summation of xi square. So we get the total value. We have to calculate 0.83. Then a0 is to be calculated. Y bar minus a1 x bar. X bar is calculated and that value y bar is given, that is 3.42. And after that we take the value of x bar, which is 0.3992. Okay, and multiply with that value of 4, that is x bar. So a1 value calculated by using this equation. So n total sample is 7. Then value of that summation of that xi yi, we have to calculate summation of xy 119.5, and then we have to subtract 28 minus 24. So some of the issue is there. Let come. Actually, this equation in that way, some slide problem is there. Okay. So the formula for a1 is n xi yi minus summation of xi y summation of yi n summation of x square minus summation of xi total square. So all these values to be calculated from previous value calculation, and that a1 bar we get. So equation y0, a0 is we have to calculate it, and a0 is calculated by y bar minus a1 x bar. So put the value and we get the equation y equals to a plus b of x, or a0 a1 of x. We can also say that this is b and this is a0. So we take the notation like a0 and a1. Okay. Same then for the another curve, we take the example same like that, y equals to a to x as raised to b2. Okay, so the data is given, xi value is given, correspondence yi value is given. So we take the logarithmic form, log of xi. So calculate that value of taking the log form of that xi, taking the log form of that yi, we have to calculate. Then we take the summation of that xi, summation of yi, summation of that log value of the all xi, summation of that yi. So we take the value. The equation is log y, taking that log of that equation, log y equals to log e to x as raised to b2. Okay, so expand the value, log x, log a2, multiply that log with a2, and that power form is in front of it as logarithmic form, b2 log x. Then we have to take y bar is nothing but the log y, and x bar is nothing but the log x, which we have already calculated. Then we take a0 is equals to log a2, where a1 and b2 is same. Then calculate the equation y bar equals to a0 plus a1 x. So all the value already given. So calculate xi is given and yi given. So take the log of x, log of y, x bar into the y bar. The log x value we have to calculate it, and that x bar raised to 2. So all the value is calculated as like equation 1. Then put the equation 1 into the a1 and a0, and finally calculate the equation y, that is log y equals to minus 0.334 plus 1.75 log x. Manually you have to work on paper so you will understand it. Okay, and then curve fitting is to be calculated by using the equation y equals to 0.46x as raised to 175. So the different types of application, the most important application is the data fitting. That means we have to fit our sample data into that particular line. So the best fit least square sense, it minimizes the sum of square residual. Some of the residual or error is to be present. So its main data is to minimize it. So the residual is being difference with the observed value and the fitted value, and it is independence variable is given. We have to calculate it and the fit the error in variable model. So this may consider instead of that least square. So I hope you all understood the least square method and along with the different types of example. Thank you.